The development plan for Greater Mumbai 2034 promises Mumbaikars 1 million houses, 8 million jobs, several open spaces and slum rehabilitation projects. But there is a wide gap between these highly aspirational figures and the reality on the ground, as there are no details on where these houses will be located, how the infrastructure will be, or how they will impact the quality of life. Is it yet another scenario where, to secure the luxury of a few, the rest will be crammed into densely planned areas as a tick-box exercise? This is the case, for example, SRA developments, where the right to life of citizens is severely overlooked. In these SRA areas, 1 in 10 persons suffers from tuberculosis, and that person may further affect 15 people across the city. This is all thanks to the misleading development control regulations that it won't be long before Mumbai is faced with an epidemic.
My name is Rao Sahib Vishnu Kamlia. I am in Devgiri Cooperative Housing Society, Lalubhai Compound, Mumbai number 43.
Like Mr. Kamre, this is the story of thousands of residents of SRA buildings living in Mumbai today who are suffering from multi-drug resistant and extreme drug resistant TB. A report by Doctors for You shockingly reveals that in order to pack in maximum tenements in limited space, 8-story slum rehabilitation buildings have been built back to back with barely any side open spaces between two buildings, depriving them of natural light and ventilation, thus leading to the spread of tuberculosis. According to a report published in Times of India, there has been a 36% rise in drug-resistant TB cases in Mumbai since 3 years.
बहन की लड़की मेरी 12 साल की थी और यहाँ की गंदे की वजह से उसको टीबी हो गया था और वो टीबी से मर गई.
मेरा नाम भोलानाथ पाल है. मैं लल्लू भाई कंपाउंड में रहता हूँ. यहाँ मैं 7 साल से रह रहा हूँ. रहते रहते हमारी लड़की को टीबी हो गया और उसके बाद मुझे भी टीबी हो गया.
रोशनी आती नहीं, इसके लिए हम लोग सुबह से लेकर शाम तक 12 बजे से लेकर रात तक हमको ट्यूबलाइट लगाना एडजस्ट करना पड़ता है. इधर बहुत लोगों को टीबी हो गया है.
दोपहर के 2:30 बज रहे लेकिन लाइट चालू है हमारे घर में. धूप क्योंकि आती नहीं है बिल्कुल, हर वक्त लाइट चालू ही रहती है हमारे घर में. छोटे छोटे बच्चों को चश्मा लग रहा है हर वक्त घर के उजाले से, रोशनी बिल्कुल नहीं है बाहर की.
What is worse that these buildings are extremely unhygienic and unlivable, littered with filth, overflowing sewage, exposing residents to severe health risks and further aggravating their situation. And this is just the start. The DP 2034 falsely promises us Mumbaikars with affordable housing with even more diluted building standards. With an FSI of 4 as per the development plan, the population density would be 1.1 million per square kilometre. Such density is unheard of anywhere in the world, which means cramming 1/3 of India's total population in Mumbai alone. High density living conditions and a reduction of the side margins create a heat island effect, which increases the temperature of the neighborhood, making it the perfect breeding environment for bacteria which causes tuberculosis. Along with SRA residents, all Mumbaikars are at high risk, given the vast mobility of working citizens across the city's transport networks. What the policymakers aren't telling us is that with such provisions, Mumbai will soon develop into a highly infectious spot for deadly TB. While the mega plans for providing affordable housing seems like a big relief, but in reality, with free housing comes free TB.